Hi, I'm BB with Gosh Darn Dandy Time. How you doing today, folks? Today, I'm going to be talking about something I've felt very strongly about for the past 19, 20 years. When I was a kid and Clinton was president, I didn't really care about politics. But then when Bush was president, or when I was in fourth grade and all my classmates, we started talking about, if we were old enough to vote, would we vote for Bush or Gore? And we asked our teachers a lot, who are you going to vote for? Who are you going to vote for? And at that time, we did an assignment. If I were president, what would I change and what would I do to improve the quality of life for the U.S. peoples? And that got me thinking to the point where annually, I would do an essay just for myself. If I were president, what would I do to change our country, to make things better? And so every year, I would do a list. Sometimes it would be 5 things, sometimes it would be 20 things, sometimes it would be 50 things. And over time, with age, with maturity, with behavioral maturity, with background knowledge changing, with understanding the news and the media, with the age and of the internet, fake news, real news, Fox News, crappy news, cable news, talk shows, newspapers, everything that the internet and newspapers and regular news sources and just media in general have to offer, as well as the state of politics, as depressing as they may be right now in 2019, I have compiled a list of 10 things, that I would do to change our country. I'm just going to list off the 10 things very quickly, but then I'm going to talk about the 2 things that are most important, or at least number 1 and number 2. Legalizing marijuana. Making animal cruelty an automatic felony in all 50 U.S. states, in D.C., in Puerto Rico. Making child marriage illegal and making 18 the marriage age in all 50 states. And term limits for Congress and politicians. And more ideas on how to improve our Congress and politicians and people who hold office, and full day kindergarten for everyone and everyone's kids, with pre-K, especially in public schools, lowering the cost of college tuition, both state level and community college. My opinions on Big Pharma. Raising the smoking age to 21 in all 50 states, plus the purchase age. And then number 10, shut down all vape stores because it's just as toxic as Camels, cloves, and other cigarettes. So, number 1, if you don't like, before I say number 1, if you don't like my opinion, then get lost. Take a hike. No one cares about your opinion. This is my opinion. This is my time. This is my video. So if you don't like, take a hike. So, number 1, I would federally legalize marijuana for all 50 states. Now, for drug dealers, you don't count. If you're a drug dealer and you're pushing 20 bales of marijuana from your home, from your business, and you don't have a license, then screw you. Go to jail. Go to prison. Do serve your time and stop distributing marijuana without a license. Get a license. Stop being an illegal dealer. You can get a license in most states. Not all, but most. A lot of states provide that license to be a distributor for dispensaries, to be a grow operator. So if you're growing it in your garage or your shed, etc., get a license. Stop being illegal. Otherwise, go to jail, go to prison. I have no time, no sympathy, no spare emotions for illegal dealers. Heroin? Goodbye, heroin. Get the hell out of here. Get the hell out of here, heroin. No one likes heroin. Heroin destroys people. Heroin destroys relationships, finances, bank accounts, puts people in financial debt. For all the doctors who are providing painkillers like Xanax and Percocet, Valium, and Vicodin to their patients for post-surgery pain management, stop. Find something that's not addictive. Because when you provide those addictive medications post-surgery for your patients, their brains become addicted. Not by choice. It's not a conscious choice for your body and your brain to become addicted to certain types of chemicals, compounds, and different elements that are going into your body that you're ingesting. Your brain becomes addicted from the pain relief and the high. And then you want more and more and more and more to the point where your brain becomes immune. Your pain management system becomes immune to that medication. So you go to a friend who has had a surgery and they have the next best medication and you keep on going up that ladder. Boom, 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 boom. You go up the ladder of pain management medications, and then heroin becomes your next best thing. And that is destructive. So no. So anyways, marijuana, it would decrease our dockets, our paperwork in the courts and the clerks, our paperwork with police. It would decrease the arrest records. It would decrease the number of people entering our jails and our prisons for using marijuana in the privacy of their own home or when they're waiting for the bus and they want to keep warm because it's cold outside. If you're arresting someone for using just a little bit of personal amount of marijuana, whether it's 2 ounces or 5 ounces, or they have possession of nearly 12 ounces on them, big whoop-de-doo doesn't mean that those 12 ounces are for distribution or resale. Ask the person what it's for. If they say medicinal, just let them go. If they say recreational for themselves and a few friends, let it go. Marijuana is not the enemy. The government is the enemy. Big Pharma is the enemy. And they want marijuana to be illegal so they can continue making money off of their Big Pharma meds, which take people's rent money away, and their utility money, and keeping a roof over their head money. Their grocery money ends up being spent on Big Pharma to control pain management, whether it's for illnesses or for medical maladies that are incurable, for degenerative diseases, for cancer treatments, for all the side effects you get from one pill, from another pill, from another pill. You may get 10 pills to treat the side effects of one pill, but then you get another 4 pills to treat the side effects of those 10 pills, and you have so many pills to take, but you have so many side effects. And marijuana is not a pill, but marijuana, medicinally, whether it's CBD oils or pot brownies or chocolate chip cookies with weed in them, or a pipe or a bong or a soda can or an apple or a blunt, doesn't matter. How you smoke it, how you ingest it, how you take it in. It's there, you know? Marijuana helps people with a lot of pains and aches and pains. And it just makes people feel better. So please, legalize marijuana. That's what I would do. All 50 states, DC, Puerto Rico, all the little islands that are within U.S. territory. Stop persecuting people for smoking a little bit of weed instead of going to the pharmacy and spending their rent money on pills that aren't going to solve the problem. That's it. That's all I have to say. The end. And then, on number 2, make animal cruelty an automatic felony.